This video presents our paper, analyzing input and output representations for speech-driven gesture generation. The task is to produce gesture motion to accompany a speech signal. Such a system can be used, for example, in social robotics. When coupled with motion retargeting, it can enable humanoid robots to produce nonverbal behavior completely automatically. We will now show a first example of gesture generated by our system. Speech acoustics were taken as the input, and joint coordinate motions were generated as the output. A common approach to speech-driven gesture generation is to split a signal into overlapping segments and produce gestures for each segment using a deep neural network. The baseline model maps speech segments directly to motion frames using a recurrent neural network. Our research contribution is to extend this framework by applying representation learning to the human motion. Our system has three steps. First, we learn a representation of human motion with the denoising autoencoder. This representation will be lower dimensional, and hence will contain less redundancy and will make the learning problem easier. Next, we learn to map from input speech to this lower dimensional motion representation using another neural network. In the final step, we combine these two neural networks. The input speech segment is mapped to the motion representation, which is then decoded back to motion. The resulting neural network is then applied to each segment of the audio in order to produce a human pose for every output frame. The baseline and proposed methods were applied to a dataset of 3 hours of Japanese language speech and co-speech gestures. We now describe our main experimental results. First, we compared our method to the baseline in terms of objective measures. As the top figure shows, we achieved 10% better average point error. The bottom figure shows the average absolute jerk, which is the derivative of acceleration. It decreased almost threefold with the proposed method. In other words, our model produced much smoother motion, as will be visible in the video. Then we conducted a user study, because human perception is the most important aspect for a social and interactive system. We asked participants to watch 20 videos, 10 generated by our model and 10 by the baseline, and then respond to 9 statements for each video. The statements evaluated the motion on 3 scales: naturalness, time consistency, and semantic consistency. The responses show that our model was perceived as significantly more natural by the study participants. We now show 2 example videos from the videos we showed to the participants. None of the videos include any post-processing to make it easier to compare the output quality of the underlying models. Here is a video for the baseline model. Here is the video for the proposed method. Finally, here is an additional example comparing the ground truth, baseline, and proposed method side by side. In summary, we presented a framework for speech-driven gesture generation using a pose space defined by representation learning, and found that the use of representation learning improved objective and subjective results. Please see the listed URLs for our paper and our code.